Welcome to the How Do I video series on Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2017. In this video, I will demonstrate how you can benefit from the cash flow forecast simplifications in Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2017, and we will get there by going through these steps. First of all, I will demonstrate how to use the assisted setup to get you going with cash flow forecasting in NAV. Then I will also show you how to adjust due dates of overdue invoices for cash flow purposes. Next, I will enter manual adjustments starting from the cash flow chart in the Rule Center. And finally, I will also demonstrate how to include taxes in the cash flow forecast calculation. Before I can start forecasting future cash flow, I should first perform some setup tasks. Using the assisted setup guarantees the fastest way to set up cash flow forecasting in NAV. The assisted setup allows me to enter GL accounts on which liquid funds transactions are posted. I can enter the update frequency and a number of tax settings. And did you know you can access the assisted setup from the cash flow forecast chart in the Role Center? So, I can access the assisted setup directly from my Role Center, where an intuitive wizard will guide me through the different setup tasks. First, I need to specify the cash accounts. As you can see, the system already suggests the GL account range, which I can change if necessary. The cash flow function in NAV can use machine learning to predict future cash flow. But for this demo, I will not enable Cortana Intelligence. Next, I can set up taxes by specifying the recurrence, the payment window, and the account type. And finally, I can finish the setup. If you have overdue sales or purchase invoices, it doesn't make sense to include these transactions with their original due date in a cash flow forecast. After all, you will never receive or issue payments in the past. With the Move Overdue Cash Flow Dates to Work Date function, the cash flow forecast includes these payments on the work date. If necessary, you can still update due dates manually, and the function is set up on the cash flow forecast card. First, I will calculate the cash flow forecast without enabling the overdue function. The current date of my demo company is January 25, 2018, and as you can see, the worksheet contains lines in the past. Here you can see a line, for example, in December 2017. This means that if I would register the worksheet, these cash flow forecast entries are planned in the past, which is of course not realistic. By enabling the overdue function and running the worksheet again, we will see now that the overdue entries are planned on the current day based on the work date. And again, for my demo company, this is January 25, 2018. So the date in December 2017 that we saw on the previous run is now planned on January 25, 2018, the work date. For more accurate cash flow calculations, you might want to take into account amounts that are not yet posted in NAV. And you can do this by entering manual adjustments from the cash flow forecast chart in the Role Center. By entering the date, the recurrence, and the end date, you can very easily specify when and how long you want to include a manual adjustment. Due to some large purchase orders, we are running the risk of having a negative cash flow in February. You can see this very nicely here on the cash flow forecast chart. Now, to prevent this, we're planning to close a short-term loan with a bank. From the cash flow chart, I can open the manual revenues and enter the loan. So, let me enter the description. Next, I will enter the date and the amount of the loan. I will not make the loan recurring, which means that I will leave the recurrence and the end by fields blank. After the manual revenue is entered, I can recalculate the cash flow forecast and the effect of the loan shows in the chart immediately. Most companies have to pay taxes, such as VAT or sales tax. These taxes impact the company's cash flow. In the assisted setup, we already specified a number of tax settings, such as the taxable periods, in most cases month or quarter, and we also entered the payment window to calculate how soon after the previous tax period finished the tax payment is registered. And finally, we can also set up the account to pay taxes to. This can be a vendor or a GL account. You can find the tax settings on the Tax Fast tab of the Cashflow Setup card. Here you can see that the taxable period is set to quarterly, but I can very easily switch to monthly if necessary. The tax payment window is 20 days. The tax balancing account type is GL account, and the GL account is 5780, which is the GL account to which my demo company posts payable VAT. If we now recalculate the cash flow forecast, the system takes into account the taxes with the predefined payment window of 20 days. To wrap up this How Do I video, let's have another look at the topics we covered. First, we used the assisted setup to set up the cash flow forecasting function in Microsoft Dynamics NAV. Then we had a look at how to move due dates to the work dates. We entered manual adjustments from the cash flow forecast chart in the role center, and we also saw the settings that we need to perform to include taxes. For more information on these topics, please visit the following links. Thank you for watching this How Do I video. This video was created in collaboration with Microsoft and the Training Center Platan. See you on another How Do I video on Microsoft Dynamics NAV.